Hello students, welcome to the session. In previous session we have discussed about Coulomb's law and Newton's law. We have seen how Newton came to know about the gravitational force by seeing a falling apple. On the same line, Coulomb derived the Coulomb's law of forces between charges. Those who have not seen that video, link is given in the description. Charges may be positive or negative. Basically, these charges are tiny particles, but for our convenience, we are going to consider them as a big 3D sphere for better understanding. Charges, if they are opposite, they attract each other. If they are similar in nature, they repel each other. These are the basic behaviors of charges. All of us should understand. So let us gap the bridge between the charges and the current. Behavior of charges for today's context is related to current. We are going to see how we get current, because current is nothing but movement of charges, and those are negative charges called as electrons. We get electrons from an atom. We can see an atom here. Atoms are also very tiny particles, and we get a particular rotation of these charges around the nucleus, like we can see here. But in particular orbit, there is a fixed number of electrons available in the rotation. Here we can see an atom of silicon where total 14 electrons are rotating around the nucleus. In first orbit, we get 2 electrons. In next orbit, we get 8 electrons. And the outermost shell, we get 4 electrons. Silicon is most commonly used semiconductor in electronics era. Now, how we get these electrons out of an atom? Because current is flow of electrons. For that, we require battery. Battery, negative terminal, forces negative charges to move towards the positive terminal. This makes bulb glow. This bulb may be any load. So if we see what is happening between the battery and the bulb, bulb is load here. Let us go inside the wire and check what is happening inside. Inside a wire and conductor, there are movement of electrons. There may be density of electrons. There are various kinds of conductor. There may be less number of electrons, or there may be more number of electrons movement in an conductor. It depends upon the quality of conductor and the application of source. So the number of charges or the quantity of charges is related with the charge density. And all of us must remember that electrons are negatively charged particles. So where these electrons actually flow? Normally, electrons flow near the surface. It is related with the concept of skin effect. This is a long journey of electron. But what is the virtual concept of electronics? Electronic is based upon a virtual concept, we are saying. Let us consider a higher level and lower level. In this higher level and lower level, if you consider an electron or any object, the nature says everything should fall from higher potential to lower potential like this. But in case of electrons, they don't follow nature's law. They start from the negative terminal, which is lower potential, and they go towards the positive terminal, which is higher potential. So, but this thing is not acceptable by the nature's law. So what we do? We consider a conventional direction of current, which says that for mathematical purpose, we will think that the current is flowing from positive to negative. This is only a direction, but not actual current. Actual current is going from negative terminal to positive terminal. So flow of electron is nothing but a current. We require a battery. If we consider a battery of 9 volt, inside battery there are small cells. So 9 volt we can divide into cells, and each cell will have 1.5 voltage. Now this battery we have to connect with the load. So battery should be connected by using conductor. So from battery terminal, we use conductor to connect with other gadget, devices or component. This is a DC battery. So from one negative terminal, electrons go out, from positive they go in, but electrons does not fly, they does not go out of the conductor. For understanding purpose, we are using charges are flowing, but in reality they are confined inside a conductor. Second thing we have to remember that there must be a closed path for movement of electrons from negative terminal to positive terminal. So that's all folks. In next session we will meet with next concept, which is Ohm's law in 3D. Till then, have a good day.